Hi folks, my name is Vivi, and today I'm going to go over my process on this Lino animation, and in general go over animating in Clip Studio Paint and some basic animation tips. I went to the Stray Kids concert in Oakland, and it was a lot of fun, so in honor of Lino, I decided to practice some animation using this Lino clip from the Maniac music video. It's always good to practice animation with references since it's a lot easier to study the motion. This video is going to be broken down into these sections: setup, demo, and keyboard shortcuts. Setup. I use Clip Studio Paint EX, which is the upgraded version. It lets you make animations and comics easily. When you create a new animation file, here are the main settings to adjust. Canvas size, so 1920 by 1080 is like your typical canvas size, but you can also do like a more cinematic wide ratio or a more square ratio. Under timeline, you can adjust the frame rate. I animate with 24 frames per second. Then you're gonna name your file, and now your animation file is gonna have a timeline panel on the bottom. Also, you can turn any illustration file into an animation. Just adjust the canvas size, open up the timeline panel, and then click this button to add a timeline. You can also change the frame rate under timeline settings. Going into timeline settings, here are the ones that I like to adjust. So first one would be onion skin settings. This allows you to change the color of the previous and the next frame, and also how many frames do you want to see in advance. In playback settings, you can adjust to play real time, which allows you to listen to audio tracks while you're animating, and you can also loop the animation. Thumbnail settings. I like to have no thumbnails because it's easier to navigate the timeline. For adding tracks, if you right-click the timeline, you can add an audio track. Make sure that it's 16 bits. So you can pause and play the animation, you can move the playhead backwards and forwards, you can zoom in and zoom out of the timeline, and you can adjust where you want the start and the end markers of the animation to be. Okay, we're gonna talk basics on animation folder and cells. So you click this button to add an animation folder to your timeline, and there are many different ways to add cells into that animation folder. One, you can click add animation cell. Two, you can select the animation folder in the layers panel and click add raster layer or add vector layer. Three, you can drag any layer into the animation folder. So if you want to add or remove the cell onto this timeline, what you're going to do is that you're going to right click the timeline, and then you can specify which cell you want. This allows you to reuse the same cell anywhere on the timeline. You can click and drag and move it anywhere, and you can also select multiple cells, copy it, and reuse it somewhere else on the timeline. If you want to remove a cell from the timeline, you're going to click that cell, click remove cell, and then it's gone. But it's still in your animation folder, but it's just not on the timeline anymore. Also, when you click add animation cell, it'll create a new cell in the animation folder, and it'll also add that cell to that spot in the timeline. So let's start animating. First, I create an animation folder for the rough animation, and then I add an animation cell. And I start with the key poses. So these are the 12 main poses I have of Lino. After I have the key poses down, I'm gonna do a bit more drawings in between those key poses to smooth out the animation. I'm gonna give a quick speed run explanation of inbetweening. So slow movements need images drawn really close to each other, while fast movements need images drawn with a very large distance change. In order to ease in and ease out, the first few frames are gonna be drawn close to each other. The middle frame is gonna have a big distance change, and then the last frame gets close to each other again. So I start off with my two key poses, and then in the timeline, I'm gonna add a cell in between those two poses. I'm gonna toggle on the onion skin and draw a pose in the middle. You draw a line between the two colored lines, right? Here's how the three poses turned out. Since I drew a lot of key poses, I didn't have to do a lot of ease in, ease out inbetweening. I just drew a frame in the middle. After Lino swoops down, I added another frame for him to bounce up a little bit. And when I scrub through this animation, notice how fast movements have a big distance change, while small movements have a small distance change. So once I have the rough animation down, I am going to add a new animation folder on top, select the folder in the layers panel, add a vector layer, right-click the timeline, and select that vector layer. Now every time I'm gonna click new animation cell, it's gonna automatically be a vector layer. Vector layers are good for lineart since they can be easily moved around and adjusted, and on top of that, you can erase overlapping lines using the vector erase tool. This kind of acts as my like cleanup animation stage, so I'm fixing a lot of continuity issues. Things that I notice is how objects or items are connected to each other. For instance, the suspender should stay close to the belt loop, which I didn't do, so I had to go fix that. And another way to fix issues is using arcs. So for the scarf that Lino has on the suspender, I drew a little arc to make sure that it follows a correct path line. For the coloring stage, I added another animation folder below the lineart, and I decided to color in grayscale and put a gradient map on top of that. The way I color in flats is I either use a bucket tool or I use this specific lasso tool. I did it this way so that I can condense everything into one animation folder, but you can obviously have a different animation folder for a different color, so I don't know, an animation folder for the skin, animation folder for the hair, animation folder for the shirt, and so on and so forth. After I did all the flats, I created another animation folder and I clipped it on top, and that's going to be for the shading. I set this folder to multiply. Okay, let's talk about my shortcuts. You can customize shortcuts under edit, shortcut setting, and going into the animation panel. So I have all of my shortcuts on the left side of my keyboard. I have 1 and 2 to move across the timeline back and forth. Control 1 adds a new animation cell. Control 2 pause and plays the timeline. Control 3 toggles the onion skin so I can see the previous and the next frame. And then finally, I have D to select layer. So if I click D and then I click the lineart, it's gonna jump to the lineart layer. And if I click D and I click the color, like the skin, it's gonna jump to the coloring layer for the skin. So that's all I have to say about animation basics in Clip Studio Paint. I went from a really, really rough sketch straight to lineart to coloring and then shading. Obviously, you can have another step for like cleanup animation. Anyway, I had a lot of fun doing this Lino animation, and I'm gonna keep on doing these short exercises. See you next time.